the implementation of the manifesto.
Speaking at the launch of the 2023 NRM Manifesto Week at the office of the Prime Minister today, Nabanje noted that the first 2 years of the 2021-2023 NRM Manifesto were largely for planning and transitioning, with at least 20% of the NRM government's aspirations fulfilled.
It is about between 20 to 27% of the commitments, and 77% of the commitments are on track. To me, this is a very big achievement, given the fact that we have suffered a lot of setbacks because of COVID-19.
She reveals that the biggest percentage of the manifesto remains unfulfilled, and about 77% is currently on track to be accomplished. She attributes the slow progress to several factors, among them is corruption.
However, government is intensifying the fight against corruption by strengthening its investigative systems within the various anti-corruption agencies to aid successful prosecution of the suspected corruption cases.
That we may not be able to achieve that one in these 3 years or 2 years remaining, but the next manifesto program, that is 2026-2030, manifesto or the NDP must make sure that all their set of programs and work plans must be achievable.
She, however, noted that they have greatly succeeded in maintaining peace, stability, wealth creation, job creation through skilling of youth, among other priorities.
Maintaining peace and security has been and continues to be the core component upon which the various socio-economic activities are hinged. Government has completed the construction of 20 zonal industrial hubs, and 14 of them have been equipped with welding machines, carpentry machines.
Some of the highlights of the performance in the implementation of the manifesto are establishment of PDM circles at each of the 10,594 parishes, where over 221.975 billion shillings has already been disbursed. Construction of 20 zonal industrial hubs equipped with enough machinery for youth skilling. The reorganization of the agriculture sector has registered steady agricultural growth to 4.3% from 2.8%.
Uganda launched the first satellite last year. This is a big achievement. And this is designed to foster technological advancement in the country.
During the manifesto week, government seeks to take stock of where it has reached and what it needs to do to fast-track implementation, but also to explain and share synergies required in the implementation process of the manifesto commitments.
I want to take this opportunity to declare the manifesto week of 2023 of stock-taking and accountability officially opened.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.